this is Capital Classic. Blast from the past.
Show and Shine.
Yeah.
Car Shine.
We're good at this.
There's so many cars here.
This is awesome. I love this. This is a lot of fun for me. I've already seen like two that are the same model that my grandparents had when I was a kid. It's the Nash Metropolitan.
Nice.
Really brought back a lot of memories.
What's your favorite kind?
What's my favorite?
This looks like a 66 Mustang over here. Maybe it's a 65.
I love Mustangs.
Really good.
I'm really partial to Camaros though, and I haven't seen a lot of Camaros. There's some Corvette Stingrays.
I like the green one.
You like the green one.
The green one. It's a Mustang as well.
Yeah, there's a lot of Mustangs.
Yeah.
This is fun because we're going to see a lot of cars that aren't necessarily at Hot August Nights, though.
Yeah.
Which is kind of fun. And I've talked to
a couple of people. Like this
truck. Yes, like that truck, which is definitely not a classic truck. But one of the things that I learned in talking to some of the people who enter their cars here is that they all know each other. It's like this big kind of family thing. There's a lot of friendly rivalries that go along. And it's really a lot of fun. And some of them have been doing it for years. And one guy I talked to, he has over $100,000 sunk into his Oldsmobile that he's restored.
Oh my goodness, I wonder what he's living in.
The Oldsmobile, probably.
That's so cool. It's a true passion.
It is a true passion. And he said he actually had to stop himself from spending any more because he said, you can keep doing it.
It's like an addiction or something.
You just keep finding new things to upgrade. It's just really cool. So from a tech standpoint, it's kind of fun because this is like the anti-tech convention. All of this stuff, there aren't any computers in these engines. These are old school engines. I mean, there's catalytic converters in these.
Some I'm looking are actually, I see that I recognize from Hot August Nights.
You'll see a lot of the same cars here that you do at Hot August Nights, but then there's a few that don't make that part of the circuit.
Yeah.
But you'll find that some of these people just travel thousands of miles throughout the season.
That's awesome.
Showing all these different cars.
I love this blue on that truck. My dad used
the blue,
to have a truck
I love
like
the
that.
Blue too. Blue is one of my favorite colors.
The shiny blue?
Yeah, shiny and blue. You can't go wrong with that.
Yeah. Ooh, look at this one.
Ford trucks are amazing. The older ones.
There's a rusty one right there behind it. That's pretty authentic looking.
Well, there's one. Did you see that? I think there's a Camaro up there that has the license plate not done.
Not done. That's
not done.
Awesome.
Yeah. So
this one has hydraulics on it. Do you see it lifted in the air? This orange one.
Oh my goodness! That orange paint job is special.
There's a pink one behind the blue one. I wonder if they're together because they're kind of the same truck over there.
You'll see a lot of the very similar models.
Wow.
Everyone loves their 57.
Oh, Born to Hop is the license plate.
That's fantastic.
That's pretty neat. I want to get in that car when it does that.
Look at the chrome underneath. Look at the chrome underneath.
Wow. It's pretty cool. Bonanza puts on things like this all the time for classic cars.
Bonanza's really good. They've really stepped up and embraced the community with events like these, and so we're really happy to actually get to be a part of this today.
And this green one over here you can live in. It's so big.
And we lucked out because if you remember, not 5 days ago it was snowing here.
I know. And now we're in shorts and t-shirts.
Yeah, you're in shorts.
You're in a t-shirt. And
no one needs to see my white Irish legs, believe me, so we'll just focus on hers.
I did get a sunburn yesterday, though. Okay, all right, we're going to go check out what we...
There's a lot to look at.
Let's talk to some car owners.
I know just the people. We'll go talk to them. We'll be right back. You're watching LoadedTV.com. Don't go anywhere. When you're full, everyone stands. Another day and you've had your fill of sinking with the life held in your hands are shaking cold. Hey everybody, you're watching LoadedTV.com and we are here at the Bonanza. They have a really amazing classic show and shine car show here, and I'm here with one of the entrants. His name is Jim Ohl. Did I pronounce that right, Jim?
Correct. Yes, that's right.
Usually very bad at names. He's been coming here for a long time, and what year is this that you've been showing?
This is a 1931 Ford pickup we got.
1931 Ford pickup?
Yes. Okay.
So now, how long did it take you to restore this from what it was originally?
It was about a two-year process through all the professionals that did it.
Okay. Now, you travel a lot for these shows, correct?
Well, for this truck, we keep it mainly in town. We do the shows in town. We have another pickup that we take out of town, but this one just isn't quite as comfortable to drive very long distances in.
Now tell me a little bit about the parts that went into this. Like, for example, this grill right here, That's not stock. You said you had to have that custom made, correct?
Custom made, yeah. I think that's probably the only one like it. So if you see another one, they stole that idea. And then pretty much we kept the parts we wanted off the original body. It's an all steel body. We had to get new fenders that were just going to be, the old fenders were just a little bit too worked over. It's got the original bumper, original lights on the front. The cab's original and the bed's original, and pretty much everything else is new.
Okay. Let's get a shot of the bed of the truck real quick if we can, because this is just impressive as heck to me. And of course, this isn't the original wood that came with the in the bed of the truck. No.
The original wood was pretty well
long gone.
Yeah, it is pretty well eaten up. But this is just kind of an idea this guy had that was doing the paint and body work, and it came out very nice, I think.
It looks amazing. Now, surprisingly, you told me something when we were talking earlier, and it just kind of shocked me. The chrome was probably the least expensive on the truck, right?
I think the chrome was if I could hold the price on the chrome, it's probably one of the cheapest prices. Yeah, everything else wasn't, but that part was.
But it adds so much to the overall appearance.
It sure does.
And it's one of the easiest and least expensive things to do.
Correct. Yeah, that amazed me too. But when we added up prices, that was probably the cheapest of all.
Now, you have another vehicle that you enter in these contests, but you've kind of stepped away from that one to focus on the Lemonade. This is the name of this is the Lemonade, right?
Correct. Yeah, it's just more of a stock vehicle. This one got a little bit out of hand, a little more of a street rod type of thing, I think you saw.
A little bit out of hand. I like that. Well, this the out of hand truck that you have here is much better looking than a lot of the stock things that come off the assembly line today. We have a lot to cover. Thank you so much for taking the time to talk with
us
today. And good luck.
Thank you.
Good luck in the competition. Don't go anywhere. You're watching LoadedTV.com. We'll be right back. Stay tuned.
His hands are meant to hold.
Stay tuned.
Joined by Brian, we're here in the Bonanza Casino parking lot. Brian, what is your title and position in this whole car show?
I'm the producer of the show. My name is Brian. I'm from Capital Classic Productions. We asked the Bonanza guys if we could come out and do a car show here, and they said, yeah, we could. So we come out here and set up a little car show.
So what's your passion behind this? Is your passion classic cars?
I love classic cars, but for me, it's more of being able to meet one another. You know, there's so many people here. There's probably 10 people here I've never met before.
Okay.
First thing they did was walk up and said, hey, I heard you're Brian, and I want to meet you. And I'm like, well, thank you. I want to meet you, too.
Oh, that's awesome.
So it's just a really cool thing to be able to enjoy. You know, we all get to talk and find out what he did to this car, this guy did to his car.
Exactly.
You know, and that's what's important. Is there's a nice, you know, group of people. Mm-hmm. And it's just really
community.
Neat.
Community.
Yeah.
How many years have you been involved doing this?
13 years total.
Oh, wow. Okay.
Yeah, this is my fifth year, I'm going on my fifth year in Northern Nevada.
What is your favorite classic car?
Mine. It's a 1965 Mustang, but I'm also a Gasser fan. So, and that's what this car here
obnoxious is. Obnoxious here is obnoxious. Loudly obnoxious, but I like it.
It is. It's scary. You want to get in, just drive it, and just do 150 miles an hour down the road.
I love it. And this thing lifts up really tall.
Oh, it's already up there. That's why they call it a Gasser. It's already lifted up in the air, and it's just... It's a mean, nasty, fast car.
And this
car.
Thing doesn't purr, it growls.
Oh, yeah. It lets you know who's boss. So
that's
it's,
for sure.
You know, he did a really nice job on the car. And, you know, we have a home for 140 plus cars, I think. And from what I was told, I haven't counted them yet. But, you know, we almost filled up the parking lot here. And it's not a free show, but, you know, it's a show that we give to the veterans. You know, we were trying to send over one veteran per show to World War II. And so that's what we're doing.
That's awesome. Okay, so do we have any car shows to look forward to in the near future?
Yeah, on the 20th of next month, our car show is going to be Hometown Heroes. It's at Michael Hull Chevrolet. We're actually almost full.
Wow.
We are within 30 entries from being full.
So what do they do to sign up for that?
Go to capitalclassicproductions.com and check it out, and we'll take care of them.
All right, awesome. Thank you, Brian. We're going to run around and go look at all the other cool cars out
Thanks.
There, huh?
I appreciate you guys coming out.
So a day when you've lost yourself completely could be a night when your life ends such a heart that will lead you to
Welcome back. You're watching LoadedTV.com. I'm Ken McKim, and I am here with a very special woman with a very special car. Carolyn, it's so nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you.
I'm very glad to see you here. Tell us about the Pink Lady. Now, this is an infamous car in the car show and shine circuit, is it not? I mean, it's really...
This car has won many, many trophies in the area. This has won the Miss Nevada Trophy, the Hot August Nights, at Hot August Nights, the Sparks Mayor's Trophy, and Dick Gamut's Award. And these are all Hot August Nights. Plus, there's been many, many awards that she has won. She's the only car that won Best of Show at Make-A-Wish twice. That's unusual for this car.
So tell us a little bit about the history of the car. When did you first get her?
I got her in 1988. Took me 8 months to build her. I ended up taking it down to paint, and I had a painter by the name of Kenny Peterson that painted it. I had Ricky Ruiz. He is the guy that owns the Nevada Rattler. He's a dragster. Okay. And so he did the engine and put the car, you know, the mechanical part to it together. And then John's Upholstery did the upholstery in the inside. But I do have the graphics on it, and the graphics were done by a guy by the name of, his last name is Alton.
Okay.
Alton Gillespie
Gillespie, okay.
Yes. And he's out of Texas. He's very hard to find.
It sounds like it, I bet.
Yeah.
Now, this kind of started as a project car because at the time you had been laid off from work and you wanted something to do.
I did. I had been working as a meat wrapper, and I decided, you know, I can't sit at home. I got to do something. And so I started working on my car, and I did it for 8 months, every day from 8 to 12 hours a day. And I was so glad to get it done.
I bet. That's fantastic. So now you showed it for a number of years, and then you kind of put it away after your husband passed, correct?
Yes, I showed it for about 7 years, and then my husband passed, and I put it away for 10 years.
And then you met someone special at your church, correct?
I sure did, and we remarried, and he was into the cars, and we started back onto the circuit again.
So how long has that been now?
It will be 7 years.
And this is his car behind you, correct? This is your husband's car.
This is my husband's car behind me. And it was unusual because we were dating and neither one of us told each other about the cars. And then I figured, well, this is getting serious. I better find out what he likes to do.
Okay, so wait a minute. This didn't come up on the first date?
Oh, no. He didn't know I had this, and I didn't know he had that.
That's fantastic. So how long did it take before you kind of opened up to each other about your secret hobby?
Quite a while. We had known each other about a year and a half, but, you know, not that way. And then all of a sudden I decided it was time to find out what he liked to do besides go to church. And that's
now,
when we did.
Is there a little rivalry between you and your husband over who wins more shows?
Not
just
at all.
Just a little bit?
Not at all.
Not
we,
at all. Okay.
We come to the shows to meet people and enjoy ourselves. That's what it's about. If you come to a show to get trophies, you're in the wrong place.
Now, a strange coincidence, if you look at the paint job, it's clearly pink, the Pink Lady, and you yourself are a breast cancer survivor just recently.
I am. I'm still in therapy. You know, I...
It'll be a year out in August?
It will be a year out from chemo in August. Uh-huh.
And you're feeling pretty good? Just
the marks are all good. It looks like I'm going to beat this thing. So
it's an amazing story, and I'm very glad that you're standing here and you're able to share the Pink Lady with us. How often do you go to these shows?
Well, this is the first time this year. Last year I was still not well enough to go, and so this is our first one this year, but we will go as often as my health will let me. And it's doing well, so as long as it continues, we'll be out there to the shows.
Well, fantastic. Carolyn, thank you so much. It's a pleasure to meet you. Thank you so much for sharing this with us. I'm Ken McKim for Loaded TV. Don't go anywhere. We'll be right back. Stay tuned.
Your hands are mine to hold. Speak to me.
By Cecilia. Yeah, and what are we standing next to?
This is a 1945 International Metro van. It's an old bread van.
An old bread van. Wow. Who does this belong to?
This belongs to Jeff Gilia from Superglow Auto Body in, here in Reno.
Oh, cool.
He built this.
Are you the girlfriend?
I'm his girlfriend, Okay. Yes.
And then are you from Reno?
Yeah, I live here in Reno.
So you guys come out here often to car shows
yeah,
and like to show it off?
Yeah, we try to participate in the local car shows and show it off and just have a good time.
You know, Reno's known for their car shows.
Absolutely.
How do you feel about this one today?
This is fun. This is a great event. Lots of people have showed up, so pretty cars.
It's fun. You get to know people and show off your cars. It's pretty neat. What's the furthest you've driven this?
Actually, we just got back from Vegas for the Viva Las Vegas car show.
Wow.
So we drove to Vegas and back.
In this.
In
1940
this.
What?
It's a 1945.
Oh, my.
The beauty of this thing is that it sits on top of a Chevy S10 chassis.
Okay.
So everything that you don't see is new. So we can go on trips like that and be comfortable and have a great ride.
That's awesome.
We get some looks, that's for sure.
Yeah, I mean, I'm looking behind me as we're talking right now, but that's awesome. There's always a pride of ownership, and it's what you guys come here to do, is just be like, check me out,
absolutely.
Look at my car.
It's fun.
All right, well, I'm sure we'll see you at a lot more car shows
absolutely.
In Reno. Yes?
Thank
you, Thank Cecilia.
You.
Welcome back, everybody. You're watching LoadedTV.com. I'm Ken McKim, and I am here at the Bonanza Casino with Martin. Martin, good to see you again,
yeah.
sir.
Hey,
you're the marketing
nice
manager
you.
Here.
Yes, I am.
So tell us a little bit about the event. What's the official name of this particular event today?
The official name, it's actually put on by Capital Classic Productions, and this one is called Blast from the Past, Show and Shine.
Okay, and this is the first year for this one, correct?
It's the first time we've partnered up with Capital Classic Productions to do this show. It's actually its own. They're doing the show. We're just supplying the location for it.
Okay, so you're just being good hosts here. Use our venue.
Yes. It's for a good cause, you know. So it's for Honor Flight Nevada, and so to be able to send a couple of vets back to see the memorial. So it was a good cause. So it's something that, and us being car show people here at Bonanza Casino, it seemed like a good fit.
Now, you guys have a long history with car shows. You,
yes.
Clearly, you're into you partner with Hot August Nights, right? You're one of the official events on the schedule this year, right?
Yes. On Sunday, August 4th, we have the official pre-kickoff party.
The official pre-kickoff, okay.
Yes, and then we actually have our own show, which is June 15th, a Saturday, and it's called it's simply titled Show and Shine. And both of our events are free.
Okay, perfect. So now, how many years have you been doing the Hot August Nights partner show?
Hot August Nights, I believe this is our it's our fifth year with Hot August Nights, and then with our own Show and Shine, we've done it for 13 years.
Okay. So what is it about the cars that Bonanza loves so much? I mean, you don't see any other casinos really getting into it to the level you do.
Well, our owner, our co-owner, Russ Shelter, is a big classic car guy, and he has a few classic cars, and so it's sort of something that's near and dear to his heart.
So now, on the official pre-kickoff for Hot August Nights, what can people expect if they come down here? What are they going to see?
They're going to see a lot of classic cars, hot rods, pretty much anything that's 72 or older. They come here to the show. And we'll probably have about 300-400 cars.
300-400, right, here in this parking lot.
Yes.
Right. Okay, so how many do you think we have now?
I want to say, I will probably have to ask Brian for an official count, but probably right around the 100, 150, somewhere around there.
Okay, so this is just 100. So if you can picture that, 300 or 400, it's going to take over all the rest of the parking lot back here, all the way out to the street, probably.
It might, hopefully.
Hopefully, yeah.
Yeah.
So now, if people want to register for one of your car shows, what would be the procedure once you announce, okay, we're having our Show and Shine, what do they do then?
Actually, they just come onto the lot, and we give them a registration form as soon as they enter the lot, and they go straight into the casino to fill out the form.
So they can do it all same day. If they wanted to do it in advance, will you have it on your website so the people
no,
can
actually,
go?
They just come in.
Okay,
and
so
we just
make
it simple and easy for them.
There's going to be food, any kind of entertainment?
We always have entertainment, and we always have a DJ, and
okay.
So live entertainment, and it's an opportunity for everybody to show off what their cars and what they've been working on for the past few years, and actually for people to kind of, it's a small community. They all know each other, and it's a chance for them to kind of get together.
I've been learning that. The more I talk to people, they all say, yeah, that there's a lot of friendly rivalries going on, and they've known some of these people for years. So yes. It really is kind of that family atmosphere.
Yeah, yes, it is. Yes, it is. It doesn't matter with, like for our Hot August Night Show, people come from all over the you know, from California, from Nevada, they come from everywhere. And it is a small community, so a lot of people do know each other, even though they're from different parts of the United States.
Perfect. Well, this is the place to be here at the Bonanza Casino. If you missed it, don't worry about it. There's going to be a lot more events like this because they love cars here. You're watching LoadedTV.com. Stay tuned. Thank you, Martin. Appreciate the time.
Thanks, Ken.
Everything is wrong. We move on alone.
I'm here with Jared. Jared, what do you think of all these classic cars?
I like them, and I like walking around and seeing them and stuff, and it's fun to look at all the classic cars.
Do you have a favorite classic car?
Yeah, I like the Thunderbird with it's flat black with chrome touches.
You know about Thunderbirds that are flat black with chrome touches?
Yeah.
How did you learn all that?
My dad's into cars, and I like watching him build cars and being with him.
Do you want to build cars when you grow up?
Yes.
Seems like fun. I like flat black, too. Is that your favorite kind of color?
Yeah.
You don't like the shiny, sparkly ones?
No.
All right, you want to go check out some more fun cars?
Sure.
You coming down here again, huh?
Yep.
Of course. Thank you, Jared.
You gotta keep it strong.
What an awesome wrap up to a beautiful day.
This was a lot of fun, I'll tell you. There are so many great looking cars here and just great stories. The pink lady was amazing to talk to her. Carolyn, really nice lady. And 1 year out almost from the last breast cancer chemotherapy
yes.
treatment she had. So
it's
she's awesome
doing
really well.
To get to know people and yeah. get all that. It's really nice. What was your favorite car?
I have to say I'm partial to the Nash Metropolitans because my grandparents had one when I was a kid, and it just brought back all sorts of memories. So that was how about you?
I love the muscles, like the SS Camaros or the Mustangs. I'm just like, I'm the loud
yeah,
ones.
Why did I guess you'd be a Mustang person? You, yeah, the horses.
I do live in Nevada, you know, yeah, wild Mustangs.
So, yeah.
You know, I also love how the people match their outfits to their cars. I think it's really
some
cute.
Some of them, I don't think it's intentional on everyone's part. But
I think it's intentional.
You think so?
You don't?
Maybe. I don't know. You know, with pet owners, they tend to resemble their pets, and car owners can, I don't know, maybe not. Just a guess.
This was fun, though. I'm sure there's many more to come. That's for sure.
There will be. I mean, the Bonanza is very much into car shows, and they love putting on their own, and as well, they are a partner with Hot August Nights, too, so they are the official kickoff party stop this year for all of Hot August Nights, so come on down here, and you're gonna see more of this, even more. I mean, this is only 100 cars or so.
You know what I love? There, you can see them, but I love hearing them. Rum, rum, rum.
There's one guy that drove through here earlier, set off like four car alarms as he drove through the parking
great.
Lot. Yeah,
loved it.
And then, the bread van thing.
Yeah, we got in there and we were just dancing
14
around.
14 stereo speakers. It was insane.
That was fun.
It was awesome. That was cool. We've met a lot of really neat people.
We
here
really
today.
Have. So if you guys want to join another car show that they have. You should.
Yeah, you should just go to the Bonanza's website. You should sign up for their newsletter. You can get, you know, informed of all these things before they happen, so you're not just watching them after the fact, you know? Because it's more fun in person, right?
And what else are you going to be doing?
Yeah, come on.
It's
get
fun.
Out of bed,
come
lazy
people. All right, we'll see you guys down your next car show.
That's right.
That's right.
For them, it's LoadedTV.com. Take care.
Wow. 14 speakers.
On the day I was born, the nurses all gathered round, and they gazed in wide wonder at the joy they had found. The head nurse spoke up.
You can feel the seats vibrate.
She could tell by the way that I was bad to the bone. Bad to the bone. Bad to the bone.
This is fantastic. 14 speakers, people. this is beyond anything you've ever heard before. Trust me.